and survivors. Oh, 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 oh.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
We're survivors.
How can you be sitting there telling me that you care? That you care.
Survivor.
When every time I look around, the people suffer in the suffering.
Giving all the honor, all the glory, and all the praise to the Most High, our power. I thank you, Father, for Yeshua Christ, our oil, and for shedding his precious blood for us. I also would like to thank you, Father, for the Holy Spirit that leads, guides, counsels, and comforts us. Greetings, brothers, sisters, and new subscribers. It is always an honor to come before you with the Word of God and speak with you on yet another blessed day, in which our topic of discussion is faith. We are living in a dark world which promotes an atmosphere for growth. Let me repeat this again. We are living in a darkened world which promotes an atmosphere for growth. I'm preaching to the choir. Listen to this.
What's up, everybody? I just got into a little confrontation with somebody, you know? I'm in Phoenix, Arizona. So this lady right here, I gotta get you. I gotta.
Why are you sitting there picking on me?
Because I'm white.
I'm picking on you. I'm white and she's picking on me.
No, I'm not picking on you. No.
Why are you doing that?
I wanna tell everybody, like, it's still racism out here. You know what I'm saying? I'm gonna tell people that.
Why?
I mean, we defuse. Listen. We defuse the argument. We defuse what we had going into. Okay, this is what happened. You guys.
Everything. No.
I wanna document this. I wanna document this.
This is ridiculous.
I want to document this.
You're being ridiculous.
I want to show people that we can
defuse. You're ridiculous.
Look, I want to show people black and white can defuse the situation. We got off on the wrong story, y'all. Her door kept hitting my door. I let my window down and said, can you please stop hitting my door? She said, why you park so close? All right, this is my truck.
I'm the white truck. This is our truck. I'm the white truck.
She like,
why you park so close?
All right, everybody. We like around the same distance from each other. And I'm like, look, ma'am, you don't have to be rude. You didn't have to be this. Look, listen, come on.
Hey,
let's do
this. I said it.
Okay,
I mean, I said this. I didn't mean that like that.
Okay.
We came off
on the wrong foot. Look, I said, look, ma'am, you didn't have to cuss at me. You didn't have to be rude and disrespectful. Right. And she said, you're probably. And I had to tell her, I had to get out my truck.
Because you're yelling and screaming.
No, I wasn't
even.
No. Listen, I wasn't yelling and screaming. I said, look, ma'am. I said, can you please stop hitting your door hitting my truck? Can you please stop hitting my door? She said, why you pouring so fucking close? I said, listen. You know what I'm saying? I said, what did I say? When you said, why you pouring so fucking close?
You said, I don't even remember what you
said.
Yeah,
okay, it doesn't matter what I said.
It doesn't matter
what I said. I said, I'm not. I said, you don't have to be rude.
Truck drivers like this.
Okay, yes. I said, you don't have to be rude or disrespectful. Are you a truck driver?
No.
Okay, you a wife?
Yeah.
You a wife?
I don't drive at all.
You don't drive at all, but your boyfriend, your husband drive?
No, truck drives itself.
Okay, so you're a truck driver?
Come on. one.
Okay, she got the little dogs right here. You know what I'm saying? I'm like, look, ma'am, you don't got to be so rude and disrespectful. I wanted to let you guys know it's still racism out here. We defused the situation. I had to get out of my truck and tell her, like, yes, I am from the hood. Yes, I'm from St. Louis. She from Chicago. You from Chicago? Illinois. Okay, she 4 hours from where I'm from. She's from the hood, too. Ain't you from the hood, too?
Yeah, you're cracking me up.
I'm just saying, like, I document a lot of things that goes on over the road, you know? I want to let you know, I told her, like, yes, I am from the hood. But if I want to catch a flight and go somewhere, I got enough money to do it. She at? Because she told me she's white and she's privileged. And I said, okay. But I don't want my ass out.
Wait, that's not how I said it. That's not how I said it.
All right, go ahead. Say how you...
You're yelling. I said, you're yelling at me. And you're continuing to yell at me. And I said, look... It's already tough enough out here for all of us. Why do we gotta go and throw each other under the, you know, rug? Why do we gotta do that?
Exactly. Yeah. You know what? I was upset because you said why you pour. Yeah. You know what? I'm sorry. This and that. You know what
right,
I'm saying? I said you don't gotta be rude and disrespectful. I did say okay. I said you probably 50 years old. Your mama should have taught you. Like you 50 years old, you should know how to respect someone.
My
you know what I'm saying?
Is nuts. Come on.
But yeah, that's my part of it. So I apologize to you.
Right.
I apologize to you, and she apologized to me. But we all need to get along. It's still racism,
right.
And I could have just got in my truck like, yeah, the middle finger. She flicked me off, and I got on my truck like, let me talk to you. Let me tell you something. Let me talk to you. So that's what happened. We diffused the situation. What's your name?
Lori.
Her name is Lori.
Yeah.
My name Muffy.
Muffy.
It's nice to meet
you. Nice to meet you.
And.
I
might see you again.
Glad to see you out here.
All right, we both working. Okay, and we don't want to be
enough
out here.
Yeah.
All praises to the Most High. It's good to see man get along on either side. However, I do remember the text saying, "The world is like a sea, and we are the fish." And the waves that are tossed to and fro are the issues of life. Furthermore, the harvest is plentiful, but the laborers are few. Pray ye therefore the Lord of the harvest, that he will send forth laborers into his harvest. In essence, the world is a garden, and you are the earth. Now faith is the seed that is planted within the dark. So then faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. But I say, have they not heard? Yes, verily. Have they not heard? Their sound went into all the earth, and their words unto the ends of the world. But I say, did not Israel know? First Moses saith, I will provoke you to jealousy by them that are no people. By a foolish nation, I will anger you. But Isaiah is very bold and saith, I was found of them that sought me not. I was made manifest unto them that asked not after me. But to Israel he saith, all day long, I have stretched forth my hands unto a disobedient and gainsaying people. Now, faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. Through faith, we understand that the worlds were formed by the word of God, so that things which are seen were not made of things which do appear.
I'm so sorry. Excuse me, ma'am.
Miss Jenny.
Mama?
Yes, baby.
Do you think the blood will come out of my shirt?
Yes, I think the blood will come out of your shirt.
Ma'am, an airbag deploys at 200 miles an hour. Your son is too small to be sitting in the front seat.
But he is okay, right?
Busted lip, bruised face. Usually when someone his size gets hit with an airbag, it's a fractured face, broken neck, maybe worse. It's like the airbag was coming for him and changed direction. It's probably defective or something like that, but your son's very, very lucky.
No, I did. I called the insurance. It's fine. It's fine. I'll talk to you later. I gotta go. Bye. SJ's fine. He is. He's actually enjoying all the attention he's getting back there. Hey, Michael, could have happened to anyone, all right? It's not your fault. Honey, look at me. Michael, what happened to your arm?
I stopped it.
However, walking in faith requires us not to walk by sight. So in reality, all sides are blinded. Come, let us elaborate a little more. The Desert Fathers. 6. Possessing nothing. 18. Some Greeks once came to give alms in the city of Ostracinus, and they asked the stewards of the church to show them who was most in need. The stewards led them to a leper, to whom they offered money, but he did not want it, and said, "Look here, I have a few palm leaves to work, and I plait them. And so I get enough to eat." Then the stewards took them to the house of a widow who lived with her daughters. When they knocked on the door, one of the daughters ran to open it, although she was naked. Her mother had gone out to work as a laundress. They offered the daughter clothing and money, but she refused to accept it and said that her mother had told her, "Trust in God's will. Today I have found work to supply us with enough to live on." When the mother came back, they asked her to accept alms, but she refused and said, "I have my God to care for me. You want to take him away from me now?" They realized her faith and glorified God. Better is little with the fear of the Lord than great treasure and trouble therewith. When I think about faith, what comes to mind is a particular individual who was a patient of mine some years ago. When I called him back, a nurse politely helped him in. As I saw him with a cane, I held the door and relieved the nurse and helped guide him back, as I knew immediately he was blind. As he was seated, I couldn't hold back the urge of asking him how he became blind. As I checked off his medical history, asked if he had any allergies, took his blood pressure, then I asked, "Excuse me, sir, if you don't mind me asking, were you born blind?" He said no. Then I asked, "If you don't mind, so how did you become blind?" It went a little something like this. One day he said, him and his fellow bikers were going bike riding, racing motorcycles, that is. As he told me, he was living that rough rider life. The women, the money, you know. and even a fine blonde, he said. As he was coming off the highway onto the main road, in which the name of that road is called Terra. Terra Road, that is. And this road is actually a main road with lots of traffic. So the boys got a little ahead of him. He was catching up, weaving in between cars. Then suddenly, he picked up speed, went to get over, and a car clipped him. He flies about 8 feet in the air, only to smack his head on the median, face forward. And he lost his eyes. Briefly, he said, before the accident, it felt like he had everything. The women, the cars, the clothes, and the jewelry. That was the life when he could see, but he wasn't happy. It wasn't until he said he lost his eyes that he could see that all he had was the very same thing that was making him unhappy. He also said, and that beautiful brown nurse you see out there is now my beautiful wife, who never left me since I entered into the hospital when I lost my eyes in the accident. However, he then wanted me to understand some things of the nature of faith. He told me he was a blind guide to an exhibit called Dialogue in the Dark. And this is where you're in the dark for several hours. So I decided to go, and I can say it was an amazing experience to understand the realities of being blind and how the other senses are heightened. If this exhibit comes to your city, I would suggest check it out. It's called Dialogue in the Dark. This
Hello.
Is it.
Hello. Keep coming towards my voice. And yeah, just follow the wall
what
around.
What you need to do is follow my voice this way, okay, but also perfect. Keep communicating with me. Reassure me that you're still
okay.
there.
Okay.
Wow.
Keep coming.
Oh my goodness.
This is amazing.
We are about to embark on a couple of hours in the dark.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Catherine, and I'm going to be
facilitating the table on this side of the room.
They will help you in any way at all that you need. And now the fun begins.
It's just pitch black darkness, and it doesn't matter where you look, you're just stuck in this well of darkness. It does take a little bit of getting used to it. It's not often that you're in pure black.
Our Messiah told us to walk by faith and not by sight. But this kind of faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. So let us go a little deeper and hear the word of God through Brother Clement. The Ante-Nicene, Volume 9. Chapter 32. We are justified not by our own works, but by faith. Whosoever will candidly consider each particular will recognize the greatness of the gifts which were given by him. For from him have sprung the priest and all the Levites who minister at the altar of God. From him also was descended our Lord Yeshua Christ, according to the flesh. From him arose kings, princes, and rulers of the race of Judah. Nor are his other tribes in small glory, inasmuch as God had promised, thy seed shall be as the stars of heaven. All these, therefore, were highly honored and made great, not for their own sake, or for their own works, or for the righteousness which they wrought, by through the operation of his will. And we, too, being called by his will in Christ Yeshua, are not justified by ourselves, nor by our own wisdom, or understanding, or godliness, or works which we have wrought in holiness of heart, but by that faith through which, from the beginning, Almighty God has justified all men, to whom be glory forever and ever. So let us now look at the works and faith of Rahab. Chapter 12, The Rewards of Faith and Hospitality. Rahab, on account of her faith and hospitality, Rahab the harlot was saved. For when spies were sent by Joshua, the son of Nun, to Jericho, the king of the country ascertained that they were come to spy out their land, and sent men to seize them, in order that, when taken, they might be put to death. But the hospitable Rahab, receiving them, concealed them on the roof of her house, under some stalks of flax. And when the men sent by the king arrived and said, "There came men unto thee who are to spy out our land, bring them forth, for so the king commands," she answered them, "The two men whom you seek came unto me, but quickly departed again and are gone, thus not discovering the spies to them." Then she said to the men, "I know assuredly that the Lord your God has given you this city, for the fear and dread of you have fallen on its inhabitants. When therefore ye shall have taken it, keep ye me and the house of my father in safety." And they said to her, "It shall be as thou hast spoken to us. As soon, therefore, as thou knowest that we are at hand, thou shalt gather all thy family under thy roof, and they shall be preserved. But all that are found outside of thy dwelling shall perish." Moreover, they gave her a sign to this effect, that she should hang forth from her house a scarlet thread. And thus they made it manifest that redemption should flow through the blood of the Lord to all them that believe and hope in God. Ye see, beloved, that there was not only faith, but prophecy in this woman. In conclusion, chapter 33, but let us not give up the practice of good works and love. God himself is an example to us of good works. What shall we do then, brethren? Shall we become slothful in well-doing and cease from the practice of love? God forbid that any such course should be followed by us. But rather, let us hasten with all energy and readiness of mind to perform every good work. For the Creator and Lord of all himself rejoices in his works. For by his infinitely great power he established the heavens, and by his incomprehensible wisdom he adored them. He also divided the earth from the water which surrounds it, and fixed it upon the immovable foundation of his own will. The animals also which are upon it, he commanded by his own word into existence. So likewise, when he had formed the sea and the living creatures which are in it, he enclosed them within their proper bounds by his own power above all. With his holy and undefiled hands, he formed man, the most excellent of his creatures, and truly great through the understanding given him, the express likeness of his own image. For thus says God, let us make man in our image, and after our likeness. So God made man. Male and female, he created them. Having thus finished all these things, he approved them and blessed them and said, increase and multiply. We see then how all righteous men have been adorned with good works, and how the Lord himself, adorning himself with his works, rejoice. Having therefore such an example, let us, without delay, accede to his will, and let us work the work of righteousness with our whole strength. I want to take this time to thank each one of you, my subscribers, for making my channel what it has become. I thank God for you and for using me as a vessel to bless you all with more word. Just as my lesson was on faith, I too choose to operate in faith by asking you for your help through offerings and donations. Kingdom Light Outreach would not be what it is without you. And as we continue to grow our ministry, we pray you will choose willingly and greatly to give as God has placed on your heart to do so. Once again, I thank you for being a part of our ministry, and you may send your donations and offerings through Zelle using the email of rhastings1130@yahoo.com or the phone number of 404-482-4728. And also, I will be putting in the description box A Tribe Called Virtue. My sister, your sister, my wife will be teaching on the law. It will be posted today. Blessings and peace. There is more word.